Good morning, everyone. It's Pastor Tim Hammy for Son of God in Burlington, Kansas. So good to be with you this morning. I hope you're having a great day. Can't believe how fast this month is going. And, well, we're going to continue on unpacking Unwrapping Christmas, the series that I'm preaching about for this month. And when you begin to think about unwrapping Christmas and the true meanings of Christmas, I want to challenge you, and in a minute, I'm going to get into the intro to this devotions, and I'm going to go into a video that I want you to watch that goes right along with this. So I want you just to pay attention, and then we'll get in the video, and I'll pray before we transition to the video. All right, so even in the most confusing and unfamiliar ways, God is at work. Sometimes, we may not understand why things happen and what things portray, but God is still at work. God is still at work in our lives. Part of what makes the Christmas season so meaningful for many of us is the familiarity. The things that we know, the aspects of Christmas, the things that are always the same, the aspects that we're going to do the same thing every year, the same thing's going to happen in a schedule and time. We like the things to be the same way every year. We are familiar with the story. We are familiar with the decorations. We are familiar with the way our family or our church or our town celebrates Christmas. We are familiar with the music. In fact, nowadays, Christmas music starts to play as soon as Thanksgiving. The turkey is cut. Christmas music is already being played, and sometimes even before that. For example, let me just throw out a couple Christmas songs, and you probably can think of this. Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. We sung a Silent Night, Holy Night, All is Calm, All is Bright, Joy to the World, the Lord has come. Grandma got ran over by a reindeer. Okay, so that one doesn't really count as a Christmas song, but most of you were still familiar with it, so you helped me make a point. We usually like and are comfortable with that which is familiar. We don't like the unfamiliar. We don't like things that make us a little uncomfortable. We like things that we know. So as we transition, we'll get into scripture. Our scripture text is going to be Luke 2, so probably tomorrow we'll get into Luke 2, but I want you to watch this video. So I want to pray for you, and then we'll get into it. Lord, I thank you so much. I pray that you bless this day. I pray that you give every listener an opportunity to share the gospel with somebody this week. In your name, amen. God bless you. Have a great rest of your day. Bye-bye.
It's Christmas. When we celebrate the birth of Jesus on what we have traditionally believed was a holy, silent night. A night that marked the birth of our Savior. A night that the King of Kings was born. And because of that, we celebrate with parties, concerts, food, and the exchanging of gifts, all of which can be wonderful things. Yet slowly, and most likely unintentionally, we have a tendency to lose sight of what that first Christmas was really all about. Before we know it, we cover up the true meaning of this monumental season with this.